Alright, next out is Mercy, the album Victory March. And Mercy are from Sweden, and they play some doom metal, heavy metal kind of thingy. But Victory March is their fifth studio album from 2002. And it's a limited edition to 500 copies from Stormbringer. What can we say about Mercy? I mean, it's a shame to say that this band is most known for having Messiah Mike Green, the dude from Candlemass, as a member. He used to play the drums and sang, and also wrote the music and lyrics, some, before joining Candlemass. This is also the reason why I discovered this band. But it was actually this dude's band, Andrea. Rest in peace, he died in 2005. But yeah, it was his band. But this is a pretty cool album because this is... this is an unreleased album. So it basically an old album from way back from 87, but it never got released. Until 2002. But it's a really cool album. It's some up-tempo doom metal. And I myself must hunt down their earlier stuff after hearing this one again. So yeah, this is a hidden gem. I love this album. It's great. So check it out, Mercy from Sweden. We're gonna jump to Merciful Fate, which we also play in the background. But Merciful Fate are from Denmark, and they play some heavy metal. And Melissa is their first album from 83. And I bought it very cheap back in the days. This is like $5. And now it's worth a lot more. 10 times more, at least. Anyway, I mean, we got the Megaforce original release on this one. This is a great fucking album. I mean, this album has more killer riffs in one song than some bands have in the whole career. And yeah, it's evil and satanic and really, really great. But I guess you guys already knew that Merciful Fate is not an unknown band. We also got Don't Break the Oath with Merciful Fate. And this is their second full-length album from 84. And we also got Music Foundation and Roadrunner original release. But yeah, this is another masterpiece from Merciful Fate. I mean, both of these albums, the first one and this one, is they are both on top 10, and really, really great. After this album, King Diamond, and King Diamond went to start his own band, King Diamond, and so Fatal Portrait was King Diamond's first release as a solo. That for me is like Merciful Fate album number 3. So I got stuck with King Diamond and almost forgot about Merciful Fate. So I only bought King Diamond stuff, and you can see that in my King Diamond collection on the letter K. But eventually I picked up another Merciful Fate album, and this is title number 9. But it is actually their 7th studio album from 99, and this is also so far the last full-length album. And we got the Metal Blade original release, Gatefold, and the poster, but it's same as the cover, so nothing to see there. But I have some mixed feeling with this album. King Diamond is doing a really good job as usual, but the music is not super strong. So their earlier stuff is much better. And then we got Merciful Fate Walking Back to Hell, and this is an unofficial live album from 2003, but it's live in Denmark, 81, so it's Merciful Fate first live performance recorded. And we got this one on colored vinyl. Sorry for the noise, but and this album comes in all different colors and shapes, but that's not true. They are all round. Moving on. Messiah. Focus. So, Messiah. They are from Switzerland and play some death thrash metal. And this is this is a compilation kind of thingy with their first demo, Power Thrash, and their third demo, the Infernal Thrashing. And it was released on a gatefold album. I don't know if you guys see that. I cannot see in the film if it was focused or not. But so if we're gonna talk a little bit about the music, the first demo, the Power Thrash, it was released in 85, and it's you know, you can hear it's a young band. And it also sounds like Hellhammer thrash, you know, some black metal elements. So pretty cool if you like that type of music. They have Hellhammer on the jacket there, so they were really influenced by Hellhammer. And the third demo is a little bit more evil, and I don't know, but it's really good. You can still hear it's a young band because it was recorded in the same year. But check out the vocals on this live track. Holy crap. Yeah, moving on. Messiah. We got another Messiah album. Same band, but with the EP Psychomorphia. And this was released in 91, and this is the Noise Europe original release. But on this album they play some more death metal, but with a lot of thrashing madness, of course. So yeah, I really need to check out more of these bands, especially the full length, which I'm missing. So I only got two demos and one EP. Moving on to Metal Church with the album Metal Church, and I really love this cover. Metal Church are from USA and play some heavy thrash power metal kind of thing, and this album is their first studio album from 84, but I got the Elektra edition from 85. So, but yeah, this is a great debut album. It's a classic. I mean, it's let's see if you guys can see. It starts out with some two great songs, really strong songs, and then we got some solid instrumental and beautiful code of rap. I mean, Hitman is like a Motorhead, Zeppelin, Lizzy kind of thing. But yeah, the singer's voice. Let's see if we can focus on that. David Wayne. Yeah, his fucking voice is epic. I mean, it really shows on In the Blood song, but yeah. Whatever. They also do a cover on Deep Purple's Highway Star. But yeah, it is a great cover, but I don't know. It doesn't top Deep Purple, in my opinion. And last out for now is also Metal Church with the album Blessing in Disguise. And this is their third album from 89. And we got a new singer here. Mike Howie. And yeah. Anyway, the whole album here is really, really great, and I also had their second full-length album, The Dark, but I don't know, I don't find it. So I got the first one and the third one, but I know I have a second one as well. But maybe it shows up in a later video if I find it, but yeah. Anyway. That's it for now.